This is Paul Jackets, and tonight we're interviewing a very interesting guest. His name is Suckit Rockit.
Right, I sing.
Well, anyway, our interview tonight concerns Suckit Rockit and the time he got screwed by a small independent record company in Hollywood. Well, Suckit.
I don't want to talk about it. Oh, I thought you were asking me about my first name. I don't want to talk about it.
There are millions of listeners and viewers out there, and all the shut-ins. They all want to find out about your problem, Suckit.
That was the name of my record. Suckit Sings for All the Shut-ins, and it was really something. I'll sing it for you first.
I wish you would.
It goes, shut, shut, you're a shut-in, but I love you, woo. And then in the back, no, that's not all. Then the back was wop, 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 do, 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 wop.
No, we happen to have a guitar player here in the studio. The union has sent one down to accompany you. We would like to have you demonstrate this song because it really does bear on your case.
Oh, well, okay. You are my shut-in. With your legs bandaged up, you can't go nowhere. You just sit and puke in a cup. Why, oh, why shut in? Why, oh, why did I break your arms and legs and your nose and put abrasions in all parts of your body? Oh, shut in, I love you. I still love you. I always have. Why do you stick your thing in your nose all the time? What are you doing?
I have a little tiny set of teeth up there that bites my fingernails.
Oh, shut in. Oh, me, oh, my. Shut in. This gets dramatic here. Shut in, oh, I love you. Oh, I've always loved you, shut in. Legs when I kicked you in the nose. Oh, I shouldn't have. Oh.
Well, let me ask you a few more questions about this tune. Did you write it yourself?
Well, I did, and that's why I wanted to come on TV and tell all the teenagers out there about it, because...
You mean to say that there's hope for all teenagers if they like to write their own song?
There is. Just keep writing in and them. And but I wrote it, and I took it to this record company, and I said... Oh, if I got a song, you should live. You haven't heard this. And then I didn't do shut-in for him, but that was a B-side. For you folks out there that don't understand a B-side, that's showbiz talk. I've been in show business for, what time is it? 7, 8 minutes, I don't know. But anyway, I took in this song called You Gone, You Son of a Gun, You.
Before we go into You Gone, I'd like to find out a little bit about what they said when you played the B-side.
They said, that's a B-side, listen. They said, that's a boner, if ever I heard one.
When they heard the A-side, they were very excited about it, weren't they?
Oh, why do you keep putting your finger in your nose?
What did they say about the A-side?
They said, oh, listen, I've heard some A-sides and I've heard some B-sides, but this is definitely one of the shittiest songs I've ever heard in my life.
I wish you'd just briefly sum up what you think of the people that you've been dealing with in the record industry.
I can sum it up by this. When you go in, kids, to try to get your record sold to a company or try to get a DJ to play your record, be prepared to drop your drawers, because you're going to get it right in the tuckus there. I'm sorry about that. But, and carry a little Vaseline or Dixie Peach or bromoquinine to suck on or something.